This video is to allow you to correct your homework from section 5.3.2. Problems are 580 through 584. So the strategy that we discovered for the area of a parallelogram is that we need to take the base times the perpendicular height. So you should have in your toolkit that the area of a parallelogram equals base times perpendicular height. And I'm just going to abbreviate perpendicular, but you may put it in whatever way makes the most sense for you. So one thing to keep in mind is that the base does not have to be on the bottom. So in this problem, the base would actually be 20, because we can see that between the two bases, 20 and 20, that's our perpendicular height. So you would show that you multiplied 20 times 25, and got 500 square inches. For B, your base would be 10, and you'd multiply by your perpendicular height of 8 to give you an answer of 80 square millimeters. Here we talked about the fact that you should have a basic sketch. This was the diagram they kind of drew. So this is showing the total distance, 0 to 3.5. This would be like her house. Well, actually, I think they showed it more this way, but anyway, distance between her house and school. And when she was 2/3 of the way, the car broke down, they had to walk the rest of the way. So basically what you're left with is 1/3 of the journey that they had to walk. So we want to know what is 1/3 of 3.5. So what you can do is, we know that of means multiply, and we're going to want to change our 3.5 to an improper fraction. So the denominator 2 times the whole number 3 plus the numerator 1 would give you 7 over the original denominator of 2. So when you multiply across, 1 times 7 is 7, 2 times 3 or 3 times 2 is 6, you get 7 sixths. That's a improper fraction, which changes to 1 1/6. So the answer is 1 1/6 miles. And again, make sure you're showing some type of diagram to represent the distance. Here you need to estimate first and then go ahead and do the multiplication. So for the estimate, they're just telling you that they will vary. But again, you also had to kind of explain your reasoning. So for A, I might say for my estimate, well, 2 1/3 is close to 2. So this is my approximately equal to symbol. And 1.5 is halfway between 1 and 2. But since I rounded the first factor down, I might round this one up since it is halfway. And so maybe I would say that my estimate is about 4. Then I need to show my exact answer. So 2 1/3 times 1 1/2. 2 1/3 I would change to an improper fraction. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7, so it'd be 7 over 3. 1 1/2 I would change to an improper fraction. 2 times 1 plus 1 is 3 over the denominator of 2. Excuse me, you can multiply before you simplify or simplify then multiply. I encourage you to simplify before you multiply. I think it's easier. So you would take 3 and divide by 3 and get 1, because that's the numerator. And then this denominator, 3, can also be divided by 3, giving you 1. So remember, you can simplify before you multiply, as long as the numerator and denominator can both be divided by the same factor. Now we multiply across. 7 times 1 is 7. 1 times 2 is 2. 7/2, again, is improper. You would change it to 3.5. So that's fairly close to our estimation here. For B, I had told you, and let's talk about the estimate first, but for the estimate, I would maybe say, all right, 5 4/10, it's pretty close to 5. 2 3/4 is pretty close to 3. So my estimate would be about 15. For the exact, remember you need to change the decimal to a fraction or the fraction to a decimal. So to change the decimal to a fraction, it's really just as easy as looking at how you say that correctly with place value. You read that number as 5 4/10. So since you read it as 5 4/10, that's how you write it as a mixed number. Okay, and then that's going to be multiplied by 2 and 3 fourths. Again, change those to improper fractions. 10 times 5 is 50, plus 4 is 54. So it'd be 54 tenths. 4 times 2 is 8, plus 3 is 11, so 11 fourths. We can do a little bit of simplifying at least. We can divide 54 and 4 both by 2 for sure. Does not look as we can divide it by 4, so just by 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2. 54 divided by 2 is 27. Okay. We'd look to see if there's anything else we could simplify, numerator with the denominator, but it doesn't look like we can. So 27 times 11 is 297. 10 times 2 is 20. And you probably would need to show the work here as to how you're going to change that to a mixed number. So you're going to divide by 20 here. 20 goes into 29 one time, giving you 20. Subtract, you get 9. Bring down the 7. 20 goes into 97 four times, giving you 80. Subtract, you get 17. So you get 14 and 17 twentieths, which is, again, very close to our estimate. They also pointed out that if you had chosen to make the 2 and 3 fourths into a decimal, which would be 2.75, that they would take a decimal answer as well. Okay. Now, for C, I should see that you multiplied and then placed your decimal point at the end. But again, before you do that, do your estimate. So this would be close to 3 times 3. So your estimate would be about 9. And again, for the multiplying, I should see that you lined it up in terms of multiplying. Don't have to line up the decimal point, but you do have to show your multiplying. And then multiply as though they're whole numbers, and then place your decimal point at the end. You need two decimal places because you have one in this factor and one in this factor. So make sure you're showing all that work. You end up getting 8 and 37 hundredths. Here, we know that she needs 80 plants, and she already has 28. We're going to subtract to see how many more she needs. So 80 minus 28 would be 52. So she has 52 plants that she still needs. They come in packs of 6. So we're going to take 52 and divide by 6. And 6 will go into 52 8 times, giving us 48. So you get 8 packs and then 4 tomato plants left. Well, the problem is, if she buys 8 packs, she's still those 4 tomato plants short. So since we have to buy them in packs, we're going to have to round that to 9 packs. So again, when you do your dividing, you see that we have 8 packs that she can purchase, but she'll still be 4 plants short, so we got to round it up to 9 packs. Here you had to come up with a combination of these to equal 75. Now, this is one that they say will work, but it's not the only one. So 6 times, in parentheses, 7 plus 5 plus 3. Because, remember, a number in front of parentheses, no operation in between, means multiply. So it's like you have a raised dot there. And 7 plus 5 is 12. 12 times 6 would be 72. And 72 plus 3 would be 75. So that's why that works. The distributive property, again, if you don't remember what it means, you can look in your ebook and click on that and it will show you. But the idea of the distributive property is to take the number in front that's being multiplied by something in parentheses and distribute it to those terms. So you're going to take 6 and multiply by 7. And then 6 and multiply by 5. You're going to distribute the 6 to the 7 and distribute the 6 to the 5. So if you rewrite it that way, you're going to get 6 times 7 plus 6 times 5 plus that 3. Or if you figured out what those equal, 6 times 7 is 42, 6 times 5 is 30, plus 3. But really the answer that they're probably mostly looking for is this, to show that you understand how to distribute a number in front of parentheses to the values in the parentheses. So that's the homework, and make sure again you're showing correct work, and then once you're done with that, you may go ahead and submit it.